The Masters of Cultural Materials Conservation is a theoretical and practice-based course. It is professionally recognised by our industry, that being the Australian Institute for Cultural Materials Conservation. My name is Dr. Nicole C and I'm the Academic Coordinator of the Masters in Cultural Materials Conservation in the Graduate School of Humanities and Social Sciences.
I was attracted to the course because really it combined all of my interests. During my undergraduate degree here at Melbourne, I studied ancient world studies and art history, but I also really loved studio arts at high school. My name's Amy Walsh and I'm a postgraduate student studying the Masters of Cultural Materials Conservation. A real highlight for me was attending the International Council of Museum Conservation Committee conference last year. It was a fantastic opportunity to network with other students and professionals from the conservation field.
It is interdisciplinary and it really is at the art-science interface, and we use all the tools from art and science to understand cultural materials. We work with the physics department to consider the way light interacts with objects. We've used laser technologies to understand the way objects behave, and we also work with object-based sources across the university, because the university has 29 cultural collections. So they become an excellent area for us to engage with and to engage with the cultural collections custodians.
My name is Yasmin Kopi. I'm studying the Master of Cultural Materials Conservation. The whole course has been wonderful, and I think it is that we've been exposed to so many different things.
In our course, we have 8 compulsory units in the first year. The first class usually is in professional practices, and that provides students with a really holistic understanding of cultural materials. And from there on, we'll go and do cultural materials chemistry, where we understand the chemistry of objects, the physics of objects. We have subjects in the field. Over the past 2 years, that's been undertaken in Yirrkala, working with Indigenous communities, and that provides an excellent opportunity for cross-cultural engagement, understanding heritage issues on site, being very different to the ones that you might find in national cultural institutions.
I've recently completed a 1-week intensive unit up in Northeast Arnhem Land. We were 8 students working on creating a collections management strategy for the museum up there. That for me really took conservation into an area that I didn't quite know existed or that I could potentially have the opportunity to follow a career in.
The course has really opened my eyes to the opportunities we can have as conservators. In addition to working in amazing public galleries or institutions, I'd really like to participate in some archaeological fieldwork. I think that would be a fantastic professional development opportunity, and it really aligns with what I'm passionate about.
There are lots of opportunities for students to specialise, and it can change each year. So that means that for students, we're graduating a different type of student with a different skills base, and that being very important for employability.